Are you an investor looking for premium market opportunities? Presenting premium and exclusive service for investors by Kalkine.
Queensland is set to welcome the world's largest pumped hydro scheme after plans were announced for a $62 billion clean energy plan for the state. The Premier of Queensland, Annastacia Palaszczuk, announced the moves on the 28th of September. A new dam in Pioneer Valley near Mackay will supply half of Queensland's energy needs with clean, reliable, affordable renewable energy. The Queensland Energy and Jobs Plan promises 70% of Queensland's energy supply will be from renewables by 2032 and 80% by 2035. Two new pumped hydros are planned at Pioneer and Barumba Dam by 2035, and a new Queensland supergrid connecting solar, wind, battery and hydrogen generators across the state. This should unlock 22 gigawatts of new renewable capacity. Publicly owned coal-fired power stations are to convert to clean energy hubs, with Queensland's publicly owned coal-fired power stations to stop reliance on burning coal by 2035. It's hoped this will generate 100,000 new jobs by 2040, mostly in Queensland. 95% of the investment will be in the state. The Premier said the visionary plan is to set Queensland up for the next century, saying the plan is all about cheaper, cleaner and secure energy for Queenslanders and is about turbocharging new investments in new minerals, batteries and manufacturing. The projects are subject to environmental approvals. It's expected that when completed, the two new pumped hydro facilities will be bigger than the Snowy Mountains hydroelectric scheme. Cheap solar electricity would be used during the day to pump water up the mountain to store it, and at night can release the water to generate electricity. Last year, renewable energy accounted for 32.5% of Australia's total electricity generation. Electricity prices rose 18.3% in 2022, which amounts to over $200 per year. The federal government aims to boost renewable energy and storage. The Australian government also plans to decrease emissions by 43% by 2030. So what do you think? Let us know in the comments section below. Don't forget to hit the like button, and you can also subscribe to our channel. And you can press the bell icon to get notifications for our latest videos. I'm Rachel for Kalkine Media.